How can I change my environment?
Yeah, it is possible to change your environment. One is to walk away from that environment to another environment, which is more conducive to you, which you may like better. But it is not easy for everyone to just move away from where they are living or the situation they are in and just move away and go to another situation. So we try to adjust to the environment. Now, this is not something I would recommend, that you adjust to the environment. This is not really an option. This essentially means that if you're living with alcoholics, you start drinking yourself, so you somehow adjust. Or you're living with angry people, you become angry yourself, so you're all shouting on top of each other, so you are one of them. The first option being moving away from that environment to another environment. And the second option is you change the environment. Can you really change the environment? Can you really do it? It is possible to affect that environment. I'll tell you a story. A young woman visits a Zen master and she tells the Zen master, "The environment at home is really bad. My mother-in-law nags me and my husband all the time. She's made the atmosphere at home so bad and so vitiated that I cannot live in it anymore. Is there something that you can do to help me get rid of my mother-in-law?" The Zen master looked at the young woman and said, "Wait a minute." He goes in and comes out from his back room with a jar full of white pills. He tells this young woman, "There are 90 pills in this. Give each pill in the morning with a cup of tea to your mother-in-law. Make sure that you sit next to her and you talk to her nicely, lovingly, so that she finishes her tea to the end. Of course, make the tea exactly the way she likes it, so that she would drink the tea. It is necessary that she finishes this one cup of tea every day for the next 90 days. The woman said, "Okay, that's not very hard to do." And the Zen master said, "I will give you one more advice. Because people may be suspicious that you may have somehow poisoned her or killed her. So I will advise you to be very nice to your mother-in-law, talk to her nicely, take care of her needs for the next 90 days so that no suspicion falls on you." Now the young woman is flustered because she really did not come here to get her mother-in-law killed. And here is this Zen master, enlightened being, who's asking her to kill her mother-in-law. But then at the same time, she thinks, "Well, it's not really my responsibility because it's the master who's telling me to do it, so I can absolve my conscience of it. I did not really ask my master to kill my mother-in-law, but that's the advice he's giving me, so it's fine. And I can certainly be sweet and nice to my mother-in-law for the next 90 days if at the end of it, I will be able to get rid of her." About 30 days go by and the Zen master sees this young woman coming into his house again with tears in her eyes and crying. The Zen master asks her, "It's been only 30 days. Is your mother-in-law already dead?" The woman replies, "No, master, I don't want my mother-in-law to die because she's such a nice and sweet person and we get along really well. And there is no problem in the house. There is no tension in the house. And everything is going smoothly. So can I do something? Can you give me something so I can reverse these effects of these 30 pills I have already given to her?" The Zen master smiles and told her, "These were only sugar pills. There was no poison." But this story teaches us that the only way to affect or change the environment is to change ourselves. When we change ourselves, the environment is bound to change. The situation we are in is bound to change. There is no doubt about it. Like in the words of Mahatma Gandhi, "Be the change that you want to see." So, what you want to see in the environment around you, be that, and the environment shall be so. If you would like to leave a feedback or a comment or ask me a question, please do so on this page. And thank you for watching this video.